Only after a few years of launching your startup, you've caught the attention of many global players, not only Asian giants, but also Goldman Sachs, George Soros. What do you think that they see in your company and in the sector that you operate in?
First of all, I think they see a great debt in Latin America, which is that over 50% of adults in this region don't have access to financial services. And so they see the opportunity to provide, through technology, much better, much more inclusive, and much more transparent financial services. And so that's not available in the region. And we've seen a flurry of innovation with Mercado Libre, with Nubank in Brazil. And so what we're trying to do is give everyone an account and an app with which to manage their finances. And that could deepen financial integration as well as financial inclusion in the region.
You're already operating in Argentina and in Mexico. Where next to?
I mean, we're not going to talk about where we haven't launched, but we were going to say that we have a lot of verticals running in Argentina. We have 10% of the country. We have 25% of the young in Argentina, 18 to 25 year olds, have Uala. And we've just recently launched insurance as well as merchant acquiring. As you have more cards in the market, people need more merchant acquiring services. There's a huge opportunity in this market. And in Mexico, we haven't yet launched savings or lending, which we both have operating in Argentina. We have over 200,000 clients. But Mexico is a country of 130 million people, where over 50% of them have never had the ability to pay for anything online. 85% of Mexican commerce happens in cash. And so we know this is a one-way street. We know that there's going to be a battle in these kinds of markets, and we're hoping to win by providing a product that is simple, easy to use, and innovative through technology.
How has the pandemic been critical as an impetus for getting some of the unbanked in the region to open up their first accounts, and how much runway for growth do you continue to see from that?
I mean, the truth is that the pandemic provided an inflection point that hastened the adoption of digital money. And so in Argentina, over the 2 weeks when there was a very strict lockdown and even the factories for cards were closed, we amassed over 100,000 clients. So when we reopened, we had more cards to print than all the banks combined. And so there's a huge opportunity in markets like Argentina, where 75% of commerce happens in cash. And as I said, in Mexico, it's 85%. And so we think that cash is going to go away in 10 years effectively in the region. As more and more of the spend goes online, goes to subscriptions, you need a payment mechanism. And so we give a universal account and a payment mechanism that is global through a MasterCard to everyone. And then we have verticals that cross-sell from there, be that merchant acquiring, insurance, savings accounts, or lending. We recently launched a buy now, pay later product that has over 300,000 clients in Argentina, and it's amazingly successful because we help people build a credit history that they didn't have before, and cash doesn't allow for that.
Does crypto play a part in your strategy?
We think crypto is super interesting, and there's a lot of innovation happening in crypto. The problem is that in Latin America, we are regulated entities, both in Argentina and very soon in Mexico. And that means that we have to abide by the regulators, and the truth be told, there is no clear regulatory framework for how to do the on-ramp and the off-ramp of crypto. And so if you only operate in the crypto space, it's easy. You can have an exchange and that works. But if you are working with Basel rules and you're working with GAFI rules for KYC and you're operating with cards that give you access to the fiat systems and the central banks, you need clarity, and there is no such regulatory clarity. And so while we would love to innovate in that space, we need more clarity from the regulators, both in Argentina and Mexico. And that's a feature in the region, Brazil, Colombia. We even see it in the US, where even last week there were changes to the regulatory environment driven by the US Senate.
Aside from crypto, how's the regulatory landscape when it comes to just fintech, not only in Argentina, but the rest of the region?
That's a great question. And the truth is that over the last 5 years, I think the regulators have realized that the future of the economy is digital. And so we cannot have societies where 50% of people have access to financial services and 50% do not. Otherwise, we ask people to believe in democracy and capitalism, but then we don't give them an account. And so regulators from Colombia to Mexico, where there is a new fintech law, to Argentina, where there's a new regime from the central bank, and even Chile, a country historically closed to innovation in the financial system, are all opening up, because both politicians from the right wing and the left wing all love financial inclusion. And so we welcome that because we think that technology gives us the possibility of cutting around 80 to 90% of the fixed costs to provide everyone an account. And so we can fix this debt that our republics have had for a long time that, you know, just like it's happened in Asia over the last decade, technology really fastens innovation and brings about a fairer opportunity for everyone to have a credit history, to be able to take a loan, and to be able to save effectively.